Hi, in this time, we are going to create a dissolve material. First, import the texture in the video, then create a material and click to open the window. Set the blend mode of the material to translucent. Next, create a texture sample by clicking while holding down the T key on the keyboard, and then set the previously imported texture. Next, create a cheap contrast node. Then hold down the A key on your keyboard and click to create an add node. Hold down the S key on your keyboard and click to create a parameter node. After connecting it to the add node as shown in the video, connect the add node to the cheap contrast node. You can control the degree of the material to be dissolved with this parameter. After this, create a parameter node once more. If you set the value in the parameter node like the video and connect it to the cheap contrast node, you may see that the texture has black and white contrast as much as the parameter's value by cheap contrast node. Next, create a 1 minus node. Connect the cheap contrast node to the 1 minus node and preview the 1 minus node. The color is inverted. The border of the black area will be the part that will shine in the future. Next, to prevent discoloration, create a clamp node and connect it to the 1 minute node. Next, create an append node and connect the clamp node to create coordinates. Next, pressing and clicking on the keyboard 1, create a constant node and connect it to the append node in state of 0. Then copy and import the previously created texture and connect the append node to the UV node of the texture. If you preview the texture sample node, you can see that the black line is displayed by the append node. Next, create another cheap contrast node and connect it to the texture sample node. After that, if you create a parameter node and connect it to the cheap contrast node, you can adjust the thickness of the glowing line with the parameter value. Next, press L on the keyboard and click to create the lerp node. Then hold down keyboard 3 and click to create a constant 3 vector node. If you want, you can convert the constant 3 vector node to a parameter and adjust it on the instance. Now, set the color of the constant 3 vector node to a value around 50 to make it glow. When you connect the previously made nodes to the lerp node as the video's direction and preview it, you can find that the color has been changed into the specified color in the part of the line shown on the texture. Create another constant 3 vector node to set the color and connect it to the base color to set the base color of the material. Next, hold down M on the keyboard and click to make a multiply node, then create a parameter node and set its value. After that, when you connect the nodes as shown in the video, you can adjust the intensity of the line color with the parameter connected to the multiply node. Finally, you can see the dissolved material when you connect the nodes to the emissive color and opacity node. When finished, save it and go back to the content browser. This is the last step. Place any mesh actor to the level from the basic of the place actor window in order to check the finished material. And then, create an instance of the completed material and apply it to the mesh placed in the level by drag and drop. Click the instance to open a window, check the parameter groups checkbox, and adjust the parameters to see the material dissolved.